Okay, here it is. I'm here for that big reveal, for that big empty bucket reveal. And welcome to you all as I share with you what this is all about. It's been a very special story and a very special journey. And as I said earlier, I'm inspired to be a part of this and the part of a little bit I can do in helping with wildlife conservation. So I'm going to take you back on a journey that started earlier this year. It actually started with somebody who essentially started out as a client and then became a very good friend of mine. Actually, that often happens, but this is such a special journey with this lady. And that was earlier this year when she contacted me and said, "I would love you to be my guest at Royal Ascot." Now, that friend is Dina Delic, and Dina was a Miss Sarajevo runner-up in the year that Bosnia blew up. And she has such an amazing story, and very soon I will be interviewing her on my show. She's scheduled very, very soon, because her story is amazing. But Dina and I got together and said, okay, this is going to happen. So the very first thing I knew I had to do is get a very special hat created that would make a difference to the dwindling wildlife around the world, and especially here in Africa. So in Kenya, when I was visiting at that time, I found Chloe Mitchell, who is an amazing milliner. Wow, her talent blows me away. And I commissioned her to make a bespoke hat for me. So, ta-da! The contents of my hat, of my bucket, is a hat. Got it the wrong way around. So the contents of my bucket is a hat. And it's just an amazing, amazing hat. I handed it over to Chloe and said, "I leave it to you to bring out something really brilliant." And boy, did she. And in fact, on my show, I'm going to be interviewing Chloe about her, the hat, and next Thursday, so that we can really give you some insight on what's happening. But anyway, Chloe made this amazing, amazing hat. Here it is. Look at that hat. Now, each part of that hat depicts something with wildlife. It's all very meaningful. It just wasn't just shoved together to make it look different. It's got some very interesting meaning attached to it. And that's why I invite you tomorrow to join me about that hat and how she put it together, what inspired her, and what it all means, because it's got a whole story. That hat is a story, which is really very exciting, and I'd love you to be part of that interview tomorrow as well. Anyway, so now I've got this big hat, and it's very tall. It's not your small average size hat, you know, a typically Ascot hat. Now I've got to travel across the world with this hat and no hat box that will properly fit it that I could get hold of. So I had to do a lot of shopping around, and I came up with my blue bucket. Ta-da! So hat went into bucket, and now the logistics of getting this hat and that bucket safely across to UK for Ascot was quite a challenge. But in the end, it ended up being an amazingly funny but precious story at the same time. Of course, when you put a hat that like that, it's pretty light. So I put it in the bucket, and when you put it in a bucket like that and pick it up, it looks like it's empty. So I was traveling all these different airports with my bucket. So my first place was to get out of Kenya, where I'd been visiting, with my bucket, and persuade them that it mustn't go in the hold because it'll just be thrown away, thrown around and upside down and tumbled about, and there wouldn't be much hat left at the end of it. And so here's me, well, it's not me because I didn't have any photos taken, but here's me what it looked like me being at Jomo Kenyatta International Airport with my bucket. Now, I had to persuade all the authorities that this was a very precious cargo, that it was very important that I got it to UK and back from UK to Kenya for this special event next week, and that it had to be handled like VIP cargo. And they listened to me, and I found I was being stared at every which way I went. I was being escorted onto the plane before the call to board was there, and talking to the people, to the cabin crew, and saying, okay, this is my hat, and getting through security with that hat. The conversations it created was really very interesting. Some people who were just completely flummoxed and floored as to what I was doing and why I was doing it, and others who really caught the bug and went, oh wow, we've got to look after this, it's like a very precious cargo, and so on. The cabin crew on my first flight were fantastic. They just said, here we go, and they put it into this special cupboard of theirs, and they said, on your way out, you can pick up your precious cargo, and so on. And then, of course, I was walking and even running at one point through the airport in Istanbul with this blue empty bucket, and you could see everybody going, what a strange lady to travel around the world with an empty bucket. What's she doing? And so on. And then, of course, getting onto the plane for Heathrow was my next step, with my empty bucket, getting it put in there. And all the way along, the doors just opened as everybody opened their hearts to understanding the meaning of this bucket and its contents and the potential, be it small. I mean, this isn't going to change the world of poaching and sort everything out. It's not going to do that. But it's my tiny contribution to be able to make a difference. And they caught it. They caught the bug. It was just so inspiring. In fact, when I got to Heathrow and my nephew Evan was there to meet me, he said, oh my word, you've still got the bucket and the hat. I was expecting that it would be taken away from you every part of the way because it's filled with feathers and da 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 da. But here you are, and you got it, and well done. So that was the story of getting my bucket to UK. In fact, this dress is another story with another client stroke friend called Sarah Ellis. And Sarah is another one I'm going to be interviewing soon on my show. She's a Harley Street hypnotherapist. And I had waited to find the dress that would go with this hat till I got to UK. And I had this very specially commissioned in Kenya by Debbie Alton. These are garnets, and this is a guinea fowl feather with a little feather. So this was ready for me and no dress. So I had to match the dress to the hat, not the other way around. And so there's another story that I'll be sharing with you with great fun with Sarah Ellis on my show when I interview her, how we came across this dress. And I would never have found it without her. And it just was made for my hat. And this is the dress I wore on the day of Ascot with my hat. Here are the photos. Have a look at it. With very special company. We had such a laugh and a giggle getting there, such a challenge getting there, actually. Many things happened on the way, but so lovely to be there and to represent Chloe as well with my hat there at Ascot, and to also show the wildlife side there at Ascot too, because a lot of people stopped and said, what is this and what are you depicting and so on. So it was great, great fun. And hopefully made a little bit of difference there as well. But of course, I had to bring that back here to Kenya so that it was ready and waiting for this big day and this big event that's happening next Thursday here in Nairobi. Because on Thursday evening at Hemingway's Hotel, Kenya Wildlife Trust are having their 10th anniversary celebrations held there. And this hat is going to become a work of art and be auctioned. It's had a special hat stand made for it. We'll talk a bit about it tomorrow with Chloe in her interview. And it's an art auction, an auction to raise funds for the trust. So, yeah, there's the big reveal tomorrow. Please come and join Chloe and I as we talk more about the story of my hat. You can't miss this story. It is amazing. The story of how this hat was designed and what it depicts, and a little bit about Chloe too, because she is one talented lady. And so I look forward to having you online tomorrow and with me on Thursday. Can't wait to have you. Sending you lots of love.